My name's Todd Flanagan, and I'm the project meteorologist for the South Texas Weather Modification Association in Pleasanton, Texas. I always had an interest in severe weather, thunderstorms, hurricanes, tornadoes, that sort of deal. So in 1995, I moved to Lubbock and did my 3 years at Texas Tech. Got my master's in 98, and it just so happened that the project here in Pleasanton was just starting up and they needed a meteorologist. Generally, let's say like on a typical day, I'll come in early in the morning, I'll go through the weather maps, the balloon soundings and stuff, just to get an idea of what the current state of the atmosphere is. And you know, if it looks like there's going to be stuff later on in the day, I'll alert the pilots, I'll brief them, and I'll say, okay, this area and this area of the target area looks like it's going to see the activity first. So the pilots have to make sure the planes are gassed up, that they're all flared, and you know, I'll brief them usually between 9:30, 10:30 in the morning. Most times things don't get going until after the noon hour, so we're pretty much ready and it's just a stand and wait sort of thing.
Kim Pickens, I'm chief pilot for the South Texas Weather Modification Association here in Pleasanton, Texas. We do rain enhancement for South Texas region and San Antonio area. Sometimes it's not too eventful, but sometimes it's interesting. Sometimes it's just more than you want to get up with. The Mother Nature has a tendency not to be cooperating at all times, but it takes some skill to stay up with some of it. Sometimes it's not bad, but generally, it's a rough ride.
I don't know if you can see that, but what I'm looking at is right underneath here is a little shelf. See it? Okay. That's what I'm looking for.
When the pilot finds the right kind of lift, which would be 500 feet per minute or greater, then he's got a button he pushes, and one by one, we can fire off the flares. The flares contain silver iodide, and the reason we use silver iodide is because the structure of one particle of silver iodide is the same as like a crystal of ice. They're very similar. So the thinking was that, well, if that's the case, maybe when we put these particles up into the really cold parts of the cloud, the water vapor is attracted to the silver iodide particles and it starts to grow into a snowflake. Because remember, this is high up in the cloud where temperatures are below freezing. So these snowflakes will grow and like take away the water vapor out of the cloud. And of course, when the flakes get too big, they start to fall. And as they fall through the warm part of the cloud, they melt and turn into raindrops.
Now, something I've noticed here since I have moved here, since I've started cloud seeding, is here, I live here close to the airport. I probably put 4 roofs on my house in a 5-year span from hailstorms here. But cloud seeding in the right fashion prevents hail. And it increases the rain and prevents the hail damage. Since I've been cloud seeding, I have not put a roof on my house. And we've had hailstorms, and over in Divine we've had massive hailstorms. That particular time, Divine wasn't in our district. So whether or not it's a given, if you get on the cloud early enough and you start seeding it early enough, you could prevent lots of different things besides increasing the rainfall. Our meteorologist could tell you more about that.
The whole idea with hail suppression is to just put a lot more particles in there to reduce the size. Because if you have 100 million particles versus, say, 100,000 particles, the 100,000 particles have more water vapor to work with. It can grow a lot larger versus 100 million. So you put the 100 million in there, and instead of getting golf ball size hail, you may end up with pea size hail. There's a lot of, I have some friends, you know, that I've gone to grad school with or undergrad, and they're like, weather mod, why would you want to do something like that? Because weather modification is kind of like the black sheep of the meteorology field, I think. And a lot of people just scoff at it because, you know, there's never been concrete proof that it works. be, and their concrete proof must come in the form of tell us exactly how much rain you produced. And that's the real hard part, is trying to get to that point. We're getting there. It's just, it's slow but steady.
This is pretty much your flight track. There. There. Okay, you're taking off now, so this is your flight. There you go. And that's the storms now. So, but this is all heading toward Pleasanton, so we're going to get rained on here in a little bit.